Hello friends, the teacher here, and our today lesson is about using the page layout view, which helps you to quickly organize your worksheet layouts in Excel 2016. This lesson might be a little long, so stay tuned and keep watching. Welcome back. My name is Rajiv, and today we will be discussing about the page layout view available on your status bar when using Excel 2016. The normal view is one that you are currently seeing on the screen, and it is the default view whenever you open Microsoft Excel with a new blank workbook. We had already discussed about the pay break preview option in our previous video, and today we will be only focusing on the pay layout view. If you are new to Excel, then you might always be struggling setting up your page for Excel worksheets, because when you start working with a new worksheet, you don't always have a good idea that where your first page is ending and the next one is beginning on the current worksheet, unless you at least see the print preview once. Then the dotted line appears indicating you about the page dimensions that have been used in that particular worksheet. This is when the page layout view comes to handy. When you click it for the first time, you can immediately notice that the worksheet view has changed into page view, and Excel divided the entire worksheet into separate pages according to the page setting that you have set through Page Layout tab, like the paper size, margins, and orientation. It is very convenient for the starters who don't know much about Excel, as they now have a page view instead of a whole worksheet view. Not only to the new workbooks, you can also change to Page Layout view in your saved workbooks as well, like the one we have here. The first thing that you may notice in the page layout view is the ruler, which appears below the formula bar and above the column headings. When working in page layout view, you can turn on or off the ruler from the View tab under Show section. Ruler helps you to quickly define and change custom margins for your worksheet. Like in this workbook, one column is getting over to the second page, and it might can be adjusted to the first page if I reduce the left or right margins. Now, I no longer need to go to the Page Layout tab from the ribbon to change the margins, but I can do this right from the ruler. Just move your mouse pointer near the gray area, and the pointer will change to the double-sided arrow, and it will start showing you the margin type and the current margin that has been defined. Click and hold the left mouse button and then move pointer to left or right side to increase or decrease the margins. Same way, you can adjust the top or bottom margins if you want to. But before you do so, here are a few more things that you might consider before adjusting the top and bottom margins. The top and bottom margin areas has been divided into two sections. You can see that within the top and bottom margins area, Add header and add footer has been displayed. If there is nothing in both header and footer areas, then the entire space will be used for top and bottom margins to leave blank area on your worksheet while printing. But if you add a header or a footer, or just click inside these sections and move your mouse pointer over the left side ruler, you can see that particular area has been divided into two sections as header margin and top margin. And the same applies to the bottom of the page, where it will display the footer margin and bottom margin. To clarify this more, if we move to the custom margin setting from the page layout tab, then you can see the margins that are being used in the current worksheet and the distance that has been used for the header and footer. Keep in mind that header and footer does not add extra space to the top or bottom margins. For instance, if the top margin is set to 0.7 inches and header is 0.3 inches, then that does not mean that Excel will leave a total of 1 inch from the top. Excel still be leaving 0.7 inches as a total top margin, but if there is a header has been typed in the worksheet, then it will get printed 0.3 inches away from the top edge of the paper. And the same applies to the footer. Means if there is a footer has been typed on the worksheet, then it will be printed 0.3 inches before the page end. You can customize the header or footer distances if you would like to. However, either you can type or can use predefined headers or footers from the page setup dialog box. But the page layout view also helps you to do the same task quickly. If you need to add a header or footer when using page layout view, then you can quickly do so by clicking on Add Header or Add Footer links. The header or footer sections are further divided into three sections: left, center, and right. When working inside the header or footer sections, then a new design menu appears on the ribbon under Header and Footer tools, from where you can use some predefined headers or footers like page number, file or sheet name, current date, and a few more options to configure. For instance, I type the company name in the center section of the header and then page number on the right section of the footer. You can see that both header and footer instantly start appearing on each page of your worksheet. Headers and footers need more discussion, which we will cover in our future lessons. The page layout view works like an instant preview on your screen. For example, if I do change the paper size and page orientation, then you can immediately have the same layout of paper on your screen and have a good idea that how the contents are getting fit on the paper. Lastly, if you have a worksheet where the data has only been filled in vertical format, means no paper has been used from right side pane and data has only been filled in following papers, and then if you add a page break, then you will instantly see that particular paper has been cut off from that particular row and the remaining data has been shifted to the next paper. So, if you want to have a live preview of your worksheet, papers and layout, then I will advise you to go with page layout view, as it will help you to quickly organize things over the worksheet. Even you can switch between different worksheet views as many times as you want. I hope the information in this video will be helpful to you and you have learned something new. Tell us by hitting the thumbs up button and leaving your comments in the box below. Do share this video with your friends and subscribe to the teacher, as there are a lot more tutorial videos to come.